Hello everyone, my name is Kate Stenyum and I'm the program manager with the SHIP Technical Assistance Team at the National Rural Health Resource Center. I'd like to welcome all of you to today's webinar, Improving Quality Reporting in Provider-Based Rural Health Clinics. We are really glad that you could take the time to be here with us today. Before we get started, I'm going to go over just a couple housekeeping details. So when you call in, your line is going to be muted. In order to mute or unmute yourself, you press star 2. And if you do have a question and you unmute yourself, please be sure to keep your computer speakers on mute because that will help us avoid any echo or feedback. You can also communicate via the chat box at any time, which is located on the left-hand side of the screen, and we'll go over any questions at the end of the presentation. There's also a file share box located in the lower left corner of the webinar screen, which contains a copy of today's webinar slides, and those were also sent out with the email earlier this morning. When you click on the name of the file in the file share box, you can then click on the download button to download the file directly to your computer. These materials also will be available on the SHIP TA website after we post the recording of the webinar. At both the start and the end of the webinar, you're going to have an opportunity to provide us with some feedback of the SHIP program through a quick question poll. You're going to see a gray dialog box pop up on the screen with a question, and then please select the most appropriate answer for your state. Today's webinar, just as a note, is being recorded, and like I said before, the link to the recording as well as the materials will be provided to you and uploaded to our SHIP website. Now I'm going to take a second before we go ahead and get started, and I'm going to have Shannon pull up the polling question. So if you can, she's going to pull up the polling question. Just take a real quick minute to answer that. It says, I feel confident in my knowledge related to quality reporting in provider-based rural health clinics. And then just choose strongly agree, agree, neutral, disagree, or strongly disagree, please. We'll give everybody a little bit of time here to answer that. Okay, oh, we'll do one more. It looks like there's a couple more coming in. Okay, that's great. Like I said, there will be a couple polling questions at the very end of the presentation today as well. Yeah, do you want to go back to my... Before we go ahead and get started today, I just had a couple things that I wanted to go over, some things that are happening in SHIP. And I have a slide here that just has some key points on it. All of you received an email from Janine Myers, who is the Federal Office of Rural Health Policy Project Officer for SHIP. And in that email, she had noted that the overall SHIP spreadsheet that you usually fill out every single year, you'll still need to be filling out the really big spreadsheet, but that one will be coming, you don't need to submit that until later with the FY19 Notice of Award. There'll be more instructions on that. So you do still need to collect all of that information, but it just will not be submitted right away. Then if you see the second bullet point, the FY19 SHIP Hospital Funding Spreadsheet, that is the condensed spreadsheet that will be submitted with your grant application. You can click on the hyperlinks right on here to see those, or they're both listed on our website as well. If you have any confusion on that, just let us know. What happened is there was a lot of questions over the page limit with your grant applications, and turning in that overall spreadsheet, many of you, it took 50 to 70 pages. Printable pages for that spreadsheet. So we made a very short condensed version of it, which you'll find on the funding spreadsheet. That's the information that needs to be submitted with your grant application. If it's confusing at all, please just reach out to me and let me know and I can walk you through anything if you have any questions. Just another reminder, the SHIP Quarter 1 report form, that's due November 6th, and there's a link to that right here. Janine had also sent that out about a week ago. And then Jeannie and I have been collecting a lot of the technical assistance questions that we've been receiving over the past month, and we have updated the SHIP FAQs. And so that information is now updated, and all of it is posted right on the SHIP website at that hyperlink. And just a reminder, this is part one of the Learning Collaborative today. Part two will be held November 20th at 2 o'clock Central. And that also will be led by the South Carolina Office of Rural Health. And the topics for the second part will be quality improvement overview, quality improvement metrics, and quality improvement methodology. So now I would like to turn it over to Sarah Craig, who is the Director of Health System Innovation with the South Carolina Office of Rural Health, as well as Dr. Greg Barabel, and he is the physician advisor for the South Carolina Office of Rural Health. And I'd like to welcome them to today's webinar and turn it over to them.
Great, thank you. So good afternoon, everyone. I am so excited to talk about the work we are doing in South Carolina. And I know Dr. Barabel is excited as well to be on the webinar with me. So like what was mentioned, this is a two-part webinar series, and today we're really going to be focusing on the how really focusing on the why of quality reporting, and then on the second portion on November 20th, we'll really get down to the how. So I am the Flex and SHIP coordinator at the South Carolina Office of Rural Health. And I wanted to give Greg an opportunity to briefly talk about his work background with everyone as well. So Greg, can you unmute your line and give a quick overview?
Hello, everyone. As Sarah said, my name is Greg Barabo. I'm a pediatrician, formerly chief medical officer for a Medicaid managed care organization here in South Carolina, and have had the best 6 months of my life working with the Office of Rural Health since I left that corporate world to come over and work with these centers. So I'm really excited to be part of this organization, really, and actually learning about SHIP along with you all, excited for my piece here and then for the quality portion that we're going to do on the next webinar.
Great. Thank you, Dr. Barabel. So please, throughout this webinar, it's definitely, the intent is to be a learning collaborative, so please type any questions you have into the chat box, and at the end of the slide deck, Dr. Barabel and I will read through the comments and give everyone the opportunity to talk about the great work you are doing with your provider-based RHCs in your state. So for those of you who do not know, the South Carolina Office of Rural Health is a not-for-profit. We have a relatively large staff. We typically have around 45 full-time employees, and we're also geographically located in the middle of the state, as you can see by the red county. I wanted to provide a quick snapshot of the primary services we have at our office. I am responsible for the rural hospital and health system consultation and the emergency rural services consultation. Also, the services that are in bold on this slide are our RHC services, and I'll talk about more of those later, but I wanted to kind of just